Hi guys! One thing you should know about me before we get started is that I think a lot.
Yes, what a revelation.
What I mean by that is that I am an overthinker, of where I will just think of random scenarios and just think about it all day. Or just think of random topics that just pop up in the top of my head. But what I'm getting at here is that recently, while I was sitting on my couch in my waffle blanket, I was watching Ink Master, because why not? And I wanted to get a tattoo, so you know, gotta watch all the tattoo content that I can. Then all of a sudden, a thought came into my brain. I predicted who the winner was going to be, just based on the first couple episodes. I mean, that's not a revelation in itself, but the kicker is that I thought about it. Does every reality TV show have the first season's winner be a guy? What I mean by that is that for a competition, the format has to have a co-ed group of both men and women competing together individually at the same time, where the man will be the first winner of the first season. So I was like, is this true? Is this not true? Or am I just overthinking it? So to put this to the test, I had to conduct some research. Serious research. So to gather a good general consensus of the different type of reality shows, I looked into many genres and chose random shows that featured both male and female contestants competing individually at the same time. So to do this test somewhat generalized in a way, I first had to look up all the different types of reality competition shows. That's gonna be a mouthful to say. Looked into all the different genres, and then I just picked a random show out of all the genres that featured both male and female contestants competing on an individual level. Therefore, I excluded some shows, like for example, I had to exclude Cupcake Wars, The Amazing Race, The Challenge, which basically featured contestants, even though they were co-ed, they were in groups or one as a group or partner at the very end. And for my conducting research, I wanted to just do individual winners based on their winning on their own individual merits and their strength in the type of show they were competing in some sort of way level. While choosing and pursuing all the different genres of reality TV shows, I looked at the genres and then I could like kind of conducted them down to 7 different categories and then chose a show each from those different categories. I also chose 7 because I wanted to keep it an odd number. So just in case, let's say I did 6 or 8, for example, and there was 4 and 4, you know, it's not conclusive. You want to get that conclusive which one had more. So of course we got to do an odd number. Now, spoiler warning, if it isn't blatantly obvious, I will be spoiling the winners of the first seasons of all these shows. So after I give a little brief description of what the show it can entail, if you don't want to be spoiled about the first season, I place timestamps in the description down below so you won't have to spoil yourselves. Or if you don't care about spoilers because a lot of these shows are pretty old. Man, that's really sad to say that. So we shall start with. Starting off first will be the show that inspired me with this big question in the first place. Ink Master. Ink Masters, for which you don't know, is a show. I'm not going to say reality TV show for every one of these because at this point, you know that every one of these shows is going to be reality TV shows. So I'm just going to say shows from now on. So if that makes you upset, I'm sorry. I'm not going to say reality TV shows every single time because that's going to be very annoying and long. And I don't want to do that to you guys. So give what you take, okay? It is a show where tattoo artists compete who become the next Ink Master and win $100,000. This show has 13 seasons, starting off in 2012 and ending its show time in 2018. One thing to note about this show is that compared to the other reality TV shows, it's kind of hard to know who's gonna get kicked off because sometimes the judges will be like, yeah, so this tattoo you created was shit. And also, I'm not a tattoo expert, so there you go. I mean, I got this tattoo a couple days ago. Clearly not a tattoo expert. I know. I got that one too. Clearly not a tattoo expert. I know. For the first season of the show, it had 9 male contestants and 2 female contestants. So clearly favoring more towards the men in the show. And the winner of the first season of Ink Masters was Shane O'Neill, making this the first point for the men, making a strong lead. So there you go, men. There's your first point.
What is that?
You know we couldn't do a cooking show without the one, the only, the legendary Gordon Ramsay. And with so many shows to pick featuring the Gordon, I chose Hell's Kitchen. So Hell's Kitchen is a show where Gordon tries to find the next cook to be in his restaurant. As the show progresses on, they get to the final 5 or 6, they squish them down into one small little group for them to compete to win a higher position in a better restaurant. Where they say the pay will be around $250,000 sometimes, so it's not that bad. It's also very odd that these chefs are competing to get a job. You know, because usually, like, a lot of shows are like, oh yeah, you'll win like $100,000, so that way you don't have to work again. I mean, you still might have to work, but, you know. But this one's like, yeah, we're gonna give you the job right now. Here's your job, have fun. So this is still an ongoing show starting off in 2005, and right now it is on their 20th season. All the teams are split half and half. You know this is going to be a pretty even split, with the first season only having 12 contestants. It was about a 6-6 even split, so pretty level playing field. And the winner of the first season of Hell's Kitchen was Michael Ray, which gives us another point for the men, leading us 2-0.
Her name's Fashion.
When it comes to fashion reality shows, or like the beauty type reality TV shows, I wanted to keep more towards making the garments rather than like showing them off like an America's Next Top Model. So I chose just fashion, which is why I chose Project Runway. Project Runway has somewhat a similar concept to Ink Masters, where its artists compete together to show off their artwork to a panel of judges. But in this one, they make garments instead of tattooing it onto people's bodies. The winner of the show usually wins some sort of collaboration or featuring with a certain brand, and they also win a cash prize of $100,000. So this show started in 2004 and is set to premiere its 19th season this year. In the first season of Project Runway, it had another even split of men and women, having it 6-6, making a 12 contestant first season. The winner of the first season was Jay McCarroll, making it another point for the men, 3-0. So far, it's not looking good for us ladies up here, let me tell you that. Nerd! For this smart category, the only one I could see really being a fit was King of the Nerds, which, if you don't know, if you like nerdy people doing nerdy things and being complete nerds and you nerding out over them, this show's for you.
You nerd.
This show ran for 3 seasons from 2013 to 2015. The winner of the show gets crowned, yes, and I mean crowned, full crown, cape, little staff, sitting on the Game of Thrones actual chair, so they get to feel like a fucking king or a queen, depending on who they are. So if that's not even more nerdy enough, they also win $100,000. So for the first season of this show, it actually had an odd number, with 11 contestants, making it 6 men and 5 women. So a little step up for the men on this show, but it's not like too terrible. The first season of the show is actually a woman. Woo! It was in fact Celeste Anderson, making that a point for the females. Go with Celeste, bringing us that point of being a nerd and being smart.
Penner's already grabbed the balls and put them up there.
So out of the physical shows out there, I didn't want to choose the obvious one, like Survivor, because everyone knows about it. And, you know, it's like kind of boring, and we're like, okay, we get it, Survivor, it's up running. But I had to choose it. Now, I know what you're thinking, Hannah, why didn't you just try to find another one? Because, do you want Survivor, or do you want Wipeout? You know, I had to choose Survivor, okay? It just was another option. Because, like, I was like, oh, there's The Amazing Race, have 2 people. There's The Challenge, have 2 people. There's a lot of the physical shows where, like, the winners were teams or pairs, and I'm like, I just want the individual. So I chose Survivor. I'm sorry. I didn't want it to be like this, but I had to. Anyways, if you live under a rock and don't know what Survivor is, it is where a bunch of contestants go on an island. So I'm not gonna explain more than that. The winner of the show wins $1,000,000, which I completely forgot as how much they won, which is this show on the list has the biggest cash prize out of any show on this list so far, which I don't know if it's because it is a long running show or because they're like, yeah, we have this budget, we'll just give the winner $1,000,000. What? So yeah, like I said, the show is still running from its debut in 2000, and it's finishing its 41st. Yes, you heard that correctly. 41st season. So the first season had 18 contestants, making it 9 men and 9 women. Another even split down on the board. And the winner of the first season was Richard Hatch, giving us another point for the men. As another classic in reality TV shows, I had to choose a singing one. So American Idol is a show where people say the saddest backstories and the saddest one wins. No, I'm just kidding. It's basically a show where people sing and whoever's the best singer wins. But, you know, if you get what I mean, you get what I mean. Wonder if American Idol usually wins a record label collaboration with American Idol, and they also won $125,000. So this show is kind of weird because it like took a little hiatus. So it started off in 2002 and ended its first chunk in 2016. Then from 2016 to 2018, it just had like a 2-year hiatus because 2016 didn't really go that well. And then 2018, it started its new season, which is still now progressively going as the 3 years it's been on. So it's on its 19th season right now. So I guess it might be still going on strong. Who knows? Now, another factor about the show that I picked for American Idol. So it's a huge group that they start with, and then they slowly break them down. So I wanted to just do it where it's like definitive, like these are the final contestants. So I'm sorry if that's like inconclusive for a lot of people. It's just like sometimes they're in groups and then like they knock more than one person off at a time, and I didn't want to deal with that. So we're doing with the final 10. So the first season's final 10 was actually 5 men and 5 women. So pretty even split, I should say about that. In the first season, we had the infamous, the one and only, the wonderful Kelly Clarkson. Yes, if you forgot, Kelly Clarkson won the first season of American Idol. Here you go, Kelly Clarkson. Put up another point for the woman up there.
Hattie. Mental institution. Crazy.
Lastly, we cannot end without talking about a drama-filled show, which in this case is being stuck in a place for a while and just creating drama and doing challenges here or there. So, yes, I could have done one of those Netflixy type shows, but I told myself that I just wanted to keep it on something that you could watch while you were doing cable. If you watch a TV with your family, you go watch a channel, it's up there, which is why I chose Big Brother. This show is, yet again, still running today, where it made its American debut in the year 2000 and is on its 23rd season. The concept of Big Brother is that they have these random contestants get brought into a house where they get stuck for periods on end, where they're monitored 24/7, basically literally everywhere in this house. And then like once a week they do a challenge that they kick people out of the house, and the winner at the end who competes in the last challenge and wins. And the winner of the show wins $500,000. For the first season, it had 10 contestants with 5 men and 5 women again, making it another even split. The winner of Big Brother season 1 was Eddie McGee, who, if you don't know, is an actor right now, I believe. That's a cool fact. And also, he wears crutches. Another cool fact about him. So that leaves the last point, the number to the man. And that concludes this experiment, hypothesis theory thing. So let's get to the conclusion. The results show that the men had 5 points and the women had 2 points, making it so that the men are more likely to succeed in the first season than women in these types of co-ed reality TV shows. Now, does that necessarily mean that every reality TV show is going to be more suited to for the man to win than the woman? Could be, but you have to take this into consideration. I only picked 7 shows and 7 random shows at that. So it could, you know, I didn't want to do every single show out there because I would lose my mind. You would lose your mind, and it'd just be all a huge giant mess. So take this little theory with a grain of salt, okay? I'm just trying to do my best, and this is what my hypothesis shows out, okay? In my little research study here, it shows that men are more likely to win than women. There you go. Now, does this conclude that all reality TV shows are going to feature male more than females for winning their first season? And that men are more likely to succeed more than women? Not necessarily. What are my thoughts about this tiny insignificant result that I came up with my weird brain thinking about what I wanted to do? I wasn't surprised, honestly, with the results that came out. It kind of re-highlighted my process, but it doesn't mean that all like the female contestants don't really try, you know, or that shows tend to cater more. It sort of solidified that for female contestants in the first season of shows, it's pretty hard for them to come out on top unless they are really, really good in what they're doing, or the men are just really terrible at what they're doing. Not necessarily, but in a similar sort of way. My thoughts about why this may be the case, because another thing about reality TV shows is that they also edit and film in ways so that they can promote certain people to be the winners and certain people to be like the losers or like the middle, you know what I'm saying, like that. So my thoughts about why this might be the case is why they feature men to win the first season rather than the female contestants is due to competitiveness between men. So men are generally stereotypically more seen to be more competitive than females and have that drive to be the winner, you know, win it all, especially with something new that they could win and be the first person to win it, you know what I mean? While females aren't usually tended to like have that sort of competitiveness in a sense, which is not true in the slightest, but yeah. A lot of guys don't tend to scream at each other a lot, or if they do, you're like, ooh, it's competitive. Rather than seeing a woman who screams at somebody who does the exact same thing, they'll be called like bitchy or annoying or whiny. And people don't generally like to see that much in that case. And I think more people who watch these type of reality TV shows may be more on the male side. So to see a man win will like, it'll create more of that relatability with them of like, oh yes, I relate to that person. I knew they were gonna win. Instead of like having a female and they're like, oh, I guess they won. Maybe they're just being easier on here. Maybe not. I'm not sure. Because I tried to like Google about why this might be the case and I didn't really see anything really. Just kind of lost. One other thought that came into my mind, having a male, like, winner, is that then for the later seasons of the show, it'll show that the contestant need to be stronger, need to do better than that first season's winner, they need to go harder and stronger, so they can compete to be a better winner than that season's winner. You know what I'm saying? With that in mind, it can be hard for female contestants to get their voice heard in these types of shows. Especially when they're competing with male competitors who will more likely just kind of be above them, like shout above them, you know, try to do like, be like, I'm above you in a way because I'm probably stronger than you are kind of thing, which is not always the case. But, and with that type of theory, it's more like relating to the glass ceiling theory, where it's really hard for women to break through that barrier to get to the top because they have to punch their way up to that top. To get to that position where people are like, oh, she is a good competitor, dang. And some might also relay about how for female competitors down the line, they show to have more like a thicker skin or show more characteristic qualities of that of men, like more tomboyish, that rather than being like more feminine in a sense, because they know that won't win them, but they need to be more like a man to win a competition. So I'll leave it up to you guys. What do you guys think about this topic? Do you agree, disagree? Have you ever thought about this when you're watching a reality TV show? Or am I just thinking too deeply into this? Probably. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. And if you like this video, please leave it a thumbs up and comment down below some ideas or maybe like future topics about why am I overthinking this so that I can do more in the future. Cause I don't know, I overthink a lot. I think about random topics all the time. Maybe this interests you. I might do more of this in the future. If you want to support me as well, you can subscribe to my channel. I'd be super thrilled if you guys did because I'm pretty new to this and I just want to create content that I'll be proud of in the future. And I don't know, I like doing weird topics. I like expressing who I am to you guys and just seeing a new face on YouTube because there's a lot of people. Why not add another one? I have links to my social medias as well in the description down below if you want to go follow me on those. You can if you want, I'm not gonna force you. But on that note, have a wonderful rest of your day again and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye bye.